How do you feel about sharing your personal emails with Google? Wait, what? You didn't know they can see everything you send and receive? Whew, well, my friend, if that doesn't make you consider one of the secure email providers instead of Gmail, I don't know what will. So let me help you choose from the list of the best and safest email options that I've got for you. Before I introduce you to safe emails, let me explain why Gmail isn't one of them. Most free email providers, including Gmail, heavily rely on users' personal information to generate revenue. By monitoring online activities and sharing data with advertisers, Google ensures its services remain free while users' data becomes a commodity. I'm not sure why people are okay with that. Imagine if your postman just opens up your letters and reads them before he gives them to you. You know the saying, if you're not paying for it, you are the product. That's exactly what's happening. Google said they stopped scanning emails for ads in 2017, but would you believe them? Yeah, nah, neither would I. They've still been accused of letting third-party developers access your emails. So your data is out there making Google money, not keeping your privacy safe. Anyhow, now that you know why you shouldn't use Gmail, let me introduce my most secure email provider recommendations and explain what makes them safe. First, protonmail review. It has more than just email, and all of its products are open source. But let's just focus on email. It's a super secure choice with its zero-knowledge architecture, meaning even Proton themselves can't see or access your data. The downside? You have to set up a recovery email. Otherwise, if you forget your password, your account is toast, and support can't help you recover it. They use end-to-end encryption for your emails, though subject lines aren't encrypted. Based in Switzerland, protonmail benefits from some of the world's strictest data protection laws, giving you extra privacy and peace of mind. I guess all of that answers the question, why is protonmail safe? Another safe option is startmail. It has end-to-end encryption covered, so your emails are locked down even when you send them to non-startmail users. Just make sure you use a password to make them safe. All your emails and data are stored in an encrypted user vault, and only you can get in with your password or recovery key. By the way, Startmail was created by the same team behind the private search engine Startpage that I covered in one of my previous videos. If you haven't seen it yet, make sure to check it out. These guys know their stuff. Tutor, formerly known as Tutanota, is another safe provider that I can recommend. And yeah, since I recommend it, of course it has zero knowledge architecture. They only store encrypted data, and only you have the decryption key. Obviously, they've got end-to-end encryption. Tutor encrypts your emails, subject, body, and all attachments. Plus, they've got an end-to-end encrypted address book and calendar, so your contacts and meetings stay top secret. Based in Germany, they follow strict data protection laws, and there's no law that demands gag orders or backdoors. Tutor email clients are also open source, while most other email providers use closed source services for captures, push notifications, desktop clients, and analytics. Tutor built their own solution for all these tasks. All right, so all three are secure email providers, but since you are not paying with your privacy, how much are you willing to spend? Protonmail offers a range of pricing plans catering to different users' needs, starting with a free version that provides basic email services, but with limited features. For those seeking more functionality, the Plus plan includes access to a secure calendar alongside enhanced email features. But if you're ready to ditch Google for good and want top-notch security, which also includes VPN, Drive, and a password manager, the unlimited plan is the way to go. Yeah, 10 bucks a month might not seem that little, but considering you get one of the best VPNs and a password manager all in one bundle, that's quite a deal. Now, there's also a family plan. While it's pricey, it can be worth it for some of you, as it covers up to 6 users and has much more storage space. Like much, much more storage space. Looking at Startmail, there are just 2 plan choices, personal or business. Either's a good choice if you just need a secure email at an affordable price and nothing more. The main difference between these two is that the business plan offers unlimited domains for your emails. Now, Tutor has a free plan available, which completely mirrors the one from Proton. While there are technically just 2 premium plans, with a lot of extra features, there is also an option to add another member for additional cost. But honestly, the value is not so great, as that cost is the same as the entire plan. The thing I do like, though, is that if you want to get billed monthly instead of the entire year, the price barely increases. But to completely gauge the value and which provider you might want to choose, we have to look into the extra features. While Proton costs more than the other two options, it has by far the most features. One of the extras is Proton Scribe, which is like an integrated ChatGPT right in your email, making it super easy to draft emails and get writing assistance. PhishGuard is your personal email bodyguard, blocking known phishing attempts and alerting you if something looks fishy. For those using third-party email clients, Proton Bridge seamlessly integrates Proton Mail's encrypted services with your favorite apps, ensuring your email stays private no matter how you access them. Meanwhile, StartMail doesn't have anything additional at all. But to be fair, it's the most affordable premium solution out of the three. Lastly, Tutor is not as packed as Proton Mail, but it has a few nice additional features. Those include event invites, which send and receive calendar invitations, and autoresponder, which allows you to set up automated responses once you're out of the office or on holiday. Another thing to consider when picking email provider is the interface. Yeah, I know for some of you it doesn't really matter, but if I'm paying for a service, I don't want to feel stuck in the 2000s. Luckily for me, Proton Mail stands out with its sleek and modern design, looking great on both desktop and mobile devices. StartMail, on the other hand, features a very simple and user-friendly interface, making it an excellent choice for beginners. Its layout is kind of like Gmail, ensuring a smooth transition for new users. Tutor's interface is the most old-school and least appealing, although the dark mode does improve the overall experience a bit. Overall, if aesthetics and a contemporary feel are important, Proton Mail is the best choice, while StartMail is perfect for those who prioritize simplicity and ease of use. Talking about ease of use, by now a decision to choose a Gmail alternative should be easy. So you might want to transfer your email. Moving from Gmail to Proton Mail is a breeze, with the easy switch feature. Just follow the simple steps provided by Proton Mail and you'll quickly transfer your emails, contacts, and even calendar. For those interested in StartMail, the migration is also user-friendly. StartMail offers a clear guide to help you import your Gmail data effortlessly, ensuring you don't lose any important information during the transition. So that would be all in this Gmail ditching review. That should leave you with plenty of email other than Gmail options. If you just need a safe email provider without any extra bells and whistles, Tutor or StartMail are solid picks. But if you want a polished security suite with all the perks, ProtonMail and the whole Proton package is my top recommendation. Just before I go, don't forget to like and subscribe. And if I forgot to mention something, be sure to leave a comment. Thanks for watching. I'll see you soon.